is a important is in a community are basically modeled or is the result of the dynamic equilibrium between two processes, extinction that is related with area, where they explain that basically the biggest is the islands, the smaller is the process of extinction because have the chance to offer more resources, and how the process of immigration is related with the isolation of the islands. Why? Because of course, the closer is the island, the most easy is the process of immigration. So the number of species can reach the island easy. And of course, it's different between more isolated, like when the island is pretty isolated. The idea of my project basically is use a trait-based approach that I want to take for the second phase, not now, but for the second phase, we are going to use the resource acquisition traits of birds to try to explain this area extinction. And now the part that I'm going to explain you is basically how the dispersal traits are related with isolation. Why? Because the theory that McCartan and Wilson explained was developed like a neutral theory. So they don't take into account here the specific dispersal traits that organisms use to reach the island. They assume that all the organisms have the same skills, let's say, or the same dispersal ability to reach. So we want to basically link how the dispersal traits that in birds, in my case, will be related with the size of the wing and how these traits are related with the isolation of the island. So for the things, I have the big question or the general question for this is, do dispersal traits limit the occurrence on isolated islands? So to understand this, my idea is try to create this space or this, this space to understand how the relation of the dispersal traits are correlated with the isolation. So basically the first expectation is we expect that the most isolated the island, the greater is the dispersal trait. So we expect like a positive relation between them. And the second expectation is more related with how much is the variability between the islands. So the more isolated the island, the less is the variability. So we expect kind of homogenization in the end with isolated islands regarding to values between the dispersal traits. So for this, basically my method is I have to work with isolation and with the dispersal traits. So for the isolation, I have the polygon of the island around all the globe, all the world, and it's more or less 85,000 islands. Of course, I have the characteristic of these islands, but the most important in this case is the isolation, that basically we take the definition of isolation to like from the shore of the island to the shore of land larger than 100,000 square kilometers. So for example, we consider places like a Greenland or like a Madagascar, like a mainland, because of the effect that can have about the source and sink and how the birds can fly between them. For the traits, we use the polygons provide for bird life that basically give us the distribution, seasonality, a presence of birds also around the globe. So the idea was basically just make intersection between these two kind of polygons and know which birds are in which islands. And after that, we make kind of a cleaning process. So the first one was which is islands that are bigger than 1 square kilometers and they are more isolated than 1 kilometer. And finally, make a validation with a occurrence list from the dataset from eBird, the Cornell University, to be sure that the birds that BirdLife assume are in these polygons are actually proved that someone see the bird in this area. So after that, we make also a kind of subset and we take all these islands and we choose birds that were terrestrial resident and not endemic divided in continental and oceanic islands. Why we do this? Basically, we use non-migratory birds because migratory birds can reach really long distance, so will be not really informative traits coming from this kind of bird. We use not endemic because we have to avoid the situation of speciation because we need to be sure that the bird that was in mainland literally fly or try to fly to the island to establish the new population. Non-introduced because this will be just noise because the birds don't use their own traits to go there. And non-aquatic or marine birds because these birds basically have a special kind of traits for, let's say, land and water. So this is going to be completely different focus for what we want. So we finished with 2,000 species of bird in more or less 2,400 islands around all the world. What was the next part? To this subset, we add all the traits that we need to use, and we have the luck to get access to the data set created for Joe Tobias, that he measured museum specimens. And then they provide us the wing measurements of the birds and also the tail length to see what was working better. And in the end, we decide to go for this trait that is called keep distance. What is keep distance? Keep distance is this measure that you can see here in these two draws and photo. And basically, the keep distance say that the larger is the keep distance, more pointing is the wind, like you can see here. And between the more pointing is the wind, the stronger dispersal ability is in the birds. Actually, this is a characteristic that was find really strong in migratory birds. So we decide to choose this keep distance, our way to measure the dispersal traits. So what basically changed in the general question, just change this. So do keep distance limit occurrence on isolated islands? But the idea is make this limit occurrence. We are not going to work with all the birds that is in the island with the subset that we choose. We decide to go for the birds with a smaller keep distance on more isolated islands and see if this bird exhibit greater keep distance value than the birds with the smaller keep distance also, but in the closer islands. So basically to resolve our hypothesis, the most isolated the island, the greater the keep distance, we are going to use the mean value for the percentile 25 of the keep distance in every island and foresee how is the variability and see the more isolated is the island, the lower is the variability. We are going to use the standard deviation for all select islands. And finally, we make the analysis of this with generalized additive models using isolation, area, and body mass like explanatory variables. So the result that we have is for the first hypothesis, the most isolated the island, the greater the dispersal rate or keep distance. We find something pretty curious. For continental islands, we find that yes, isolation have a really strong effect on keep distance, but just after crossing the 380 kilometers. Before that, let's say that the isolation really doesn't have any effect in the morphology of this trait. Like I don't have any effect in the value of this trait, except when the islands start to be really, really, really isolated. And for the oceanic islands, we find that is constantly is positive. So it's basically what we were expecting in our hypothesis. And it's across all the islands. The part that is pretty curious here is this pink squaddle that you see here is basically exactly how much is the isolation. So if you see it's also not too much influence, so they also can have of relation. That means that it's not just because it's oceanic, it's because the isolation have a really strong influence. But also if you see this red squaddle, that means that is the scale of the effect that I have in this part, which means that in continental islands, in this area, the effect gets super strong because we're talking effect for more than 20. But in oceanic island, despite that the effect is across all the isolation, the effect is just until 7.5, which means that the effect is slower, but it's more constant across all the isolation in oceanic islands. If you see this from one like a spatial scale, I can show you here, for example, this is for continental island. Again, here the graphic. The biggest is the ball, the circle, not the ball, the circle is the biggest is the keep distance. And in this traffic light, you can see red, the more isolated islands, and the blue one is the closer one. So basically my main interest is the biggest circle in the red area. So basically it's in the one that you can look at the list. You can see here, and it's an island in Alaska that basically the bird with the smaller keep distance is a Corvus corax. It's a bird that is completely omnivorous, can eat absolutely everything. But also if you see the island, I mean, you cannot see really well here, but from the picture, it's an island that is pretty, doesn't have any kind of natural cover. is basically pretty like kind of desert. They cannot find too much things. And this is pretty curious because the second one that is more or less this one, let's say that is also big circle, but it's also yellow. That is this one we can find in close to Japan. And is this Motacilla alba that basically is a bird that is insectivore. But if you see the land cover, it's completely natural land cover that have green areas. And it's the same effect in the Malayan archipelago that we can find this rich swift, but it's also green. And the last two birds are insectivores, but also this is related with what is provided for the island itself. So for the oceanic islands, in other way, was more possible, like for this shore effect that I told you in the beginning here that you can see, the biggest the biggest skip distance is also the closer one. Like let's say they are pretty close, but like you can see here again, really similar with what happened in Alaska is the smaller skip distance is a really big bird. This is a Tito alba. And the island also doesn't have too much land cover. And that means that they are basically pretty like predators and so on. And finally, we have also here that is the most isolated islands. The keep distance is not the biggest one, but again, we have this this bird that is also green area cover, insectivorous, and also is also frugivorous. And here, that is in the Azores Island, also green area and insectivorous birds. The last result finally is this one, that is continental and oceanic islands, about the second expectation. The more isolated the island, the lower is the variability of the dispersal traits. And that don't feel our expectation like we have in this graphic. We were expected that they go literally like this, like go down. But that just showed that, for example, in continental islands, until the 200 kilometers of isolation, looks like the variability is having like an increase in the variability, then go down, that is close to what we were expected, and then it's stable. But for oceanic islands, it looks like in the beginning it's pretty wiggling, but it's not really strong, and finally gets super high. So that means that the more isolated island, the more variability of values in keep distance we can find. Basically, this squirrel here show literal what is all the measurement here. So that show also that the dispersal and the variability is also stronger in oceanic islands, but it's positive. So the take home message basically is the more isolated, related with my question is, the more isolated the island, the greater is the dispersal traits of birds. Yes, we can see that in oceanic and continental islands. The more isolated the island, the lower is the variability of the dispersal traits. No, we couldn't say that now. We will say that actually is the opposite, is greater variability, increase the variability, but also we assume that this is related, like I show you, with the vegetation structure in the islands and probably with the area that we have to explore that part again. And for the dispersal traits, limit the occurrence on the island, we will say yes, they do it. But also, this is also possible not just in oceanic, also in continental islands. But we find that maybe this number is important to take into account how it's changing the isolation and how the isolation have an influence. And finally, the area have an influence for sure in the behavior and not just in the keep distance, but also in the dynamic of the structure of the oceanic islands birds. And the body mass, despite that, don't play a direct role with the isolation, for sure have a strong correlation also with the dispersal traits of birds. And thank you for your attention. And I'm sorry if I talk so fast. And I think that I exceed my time too.
That's totally fine. Really great talk. Yeah, thank you very much. There's been some questions on Slack. In order though to keep things on time, I'm gonna suggest you have a look at them yourself on Slack, and other people can ask, of course, other questions. I suggest we have a little break now.